Hi guys, Squirrel here. If you remember at the end of the last video, I was wondering what to do about my truck because I'd left my logging trailer bit behind. Well, what I decided to do was teleport my truck back to the garage where I got it repaired, because I'm not on hardcore, I can do that. Got it repaired, got myself a new trailer, and now I've driven out of the garage and I'm just basically trying to get to this bloody thing. It's proving harder than it looks. Come on. There we go. Put the brake on, show where we are. So spinning round. I was here and I teleported back to the garage, got a new trailer. So that one's still lying around in the mud, interestingly. And I drove across here. I wanted to unlock this stuff because I wanted to see the whole map. So I'm just trying to get this and then get that before I then head back to get some more logs. If you look at the top of the volcano, there is actually another vehicle. So I may have to... Actually, you know what I could do? I could go and unlock that and then get over here and drive up there to find out what that is and then head on down to get more logs, because I still need to get two more lots of logs, or rather another medium set of logs back over there. But that would be interesting because I'd unlock a new vehicle. And then the only thing that's clogged then is this bit over here. And I've done one of the objectives. I'm not sure how many there are. Top left, it says progress. Well, actually, I think there's only one objective by the look of it. Interestingly. So, yeah, there's only one locked vehicle left on the map. I'm wondering what's up here, if anything, then. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's all I need to do. I don't really need that garage by the look of it. Anyway, let's... well, that's for another decision for later. In the interest of postponing decisions until you actually need to make them. Let's carry on. See where this takes us. Because we appear to be going straight, pretty much straight for this cloak. Two cloaks in relatively close proximity to each other. Having said that, the terrain is awful. Really difficult terrain. Whoa. I'm thinking about not going that way. I'm thinking about going left. Oh my god! I'm just pushing the mountain. Oh god, grief. Wow, look at that! I just excavated the ground. I think I'm stuck. I actually think I'm stuck. That is a mammoth drop. I need to get myself out of this. Right, let's try that again, because all I managed to do... Look at that, that's amazing. I've never seen terrain deformation like that. It's hilarious. The front of the truck just... Imagine being in cockpit view when that happened. With your face completely in the mud. Let's go this way a bit. No, I don't want to take the tree with me. I'm stuck on the tree. Oh my god. I'm actually stuck on the tree. There we go. That tree is amazingly resilient. Well, that was interesting. Like I say, the terrain is horrendous around here. Oh, there it is, straight ahead. That was a wise move, turning left. I should just be able to let it roll down here. Power it. Oh! That turn. The momentum just took it in a straight line. My wheels were turning, but it doesn't make any difference in this vehicle sometimes. It'll just go where it wants to. But again, look at that. It seems easy enough to get to. Can I just go through those trees? I don't think I can. Oh, look at that, I'm so close. And yet so far. This could end badly. This could end really badly. Okay, cloaking removed. Brute force straight in. Sometimes, like I say, it just works. Particularly in a vehicle like this. Right. Awesome! Look at that. Now we can see. Really see what's going on now. Okay, so if I want to get to the top of that mountain, I need to go straight on. And where's the road system? It doesn't look like you can get to it that way. I'm thinking that's too steep. You've got to come down that road here. Which basically means... could go right or left. If I just go straight left and then do a right down there. That should do it. As long as it is short, as they say. So I need to go keep left a little bit. Out of here. Oh, I remember this. This is a nasty bit of the map. A very, very waterlogged bit of the map. The UAZ can get stuck here so easily. Should be alright in this though. There it is, there's the mountain. Look at the volcano up there. You can see right at the top, that's where I need to get. We cannot get there that way. So we're going to have to go this way. Power our way up this hill. It's good having those cloaks removed. It really helps to see what the hell's going on. Get away without difflock, I think. Maybe I'm wrong about that. Nope, we need difflock. Can't get the traction. Come on, lad. Up you get. I think there was a shortcut through here. Stop there a sec. Here. Here's the shortcut. If I kind of hang left, I can follow it around this way and then double back. I think that's the way to go. You need to start turning way before you want to actually turn. Like that. Over the top. There he goes. It's not helping carrying this trailer around, but quite frankly, the idea of going back for it, it's just going to have to come with me for the journey. At least I'm carrying it the right way this time. Will I get stuck in there or not? That's the question. It wants me to go around, but I reckon this thing can get through that. You never know how deep that is until you start getting into it. It could just be a massive sinkhole, or it could be 2 feet deep. There's no way of knowing. It'd be cool if you could just kind of get out the vehicle with a stick and kind of stick your stick in the mud and see how deep it goes. Interestingly enough, when I was asking the developers on the live stream, some people were asking for all kinds of things that would make the game effectively easier. And their answer to that was, no, we want the game to be hard. We want it to be a challenge. And then people were saying, well, can we have like a desert setting and a snow setting? And again, and I kind of understand the answer to this one. You know, they don't want to do an urban setting, for example. Somebody asked about an urban setting. They're like, no, we don't want to do that. The game's called Spin Tires. You can't really have your tyres spin in an urban setting. But you could in a snow setting, so I reckon a snow setting is a possibility. Maybe even a sand. You know, if the sand's thick enough, you can get your tyres to spin through that. Don't know. But I reckon snow's got to be the obvious one. Snow and ice. That's blatant spin tyres. Mud is fun, don't get me wrong. But, you know, as soon as you give somebody a game like this, like, oh, it'd be so good to be able to do it in the snow and the ice and the mud and the rain and the wind and the dirt, you know, the sand. And I'm just thinking, we need to go left here. Talking too much and not really concentrating. Put some lights on. And then people were saying, can we have animals in this? It'd be great if you could see wildlife kicking around. I'm like, well, yeah, we could do that. You know. Not really sure what the point is. The developers were like, I'm not really sure what the point is of that, but I think it might have been left though. Yeah, it is. But I get where people are coming from. It's what I've said in Eurotruck about a lived-in world. If you're driving around in the wilderness like this, although the animals are pointless, don't make much sense, they kind of help with the lived-in feel. They make it feel even more realistic. God, this thing doesn't want to turn. Come on. Little tree. You've had your day. We're not getting points for conservation. We're getting points for delivery. Rah. Come on, up you get. This is the road to the volcano. Nighttime volcano trip. The only problem is if you accelerate time, you lose fuel, so I'd like to see the volcano in the day, to be honest. Not sure if I want to lose fuel over it though. I tell you what, you couldn't go up here with logs on the back. This is really, really steep. Now that, I think, is the vehicle. Look at that. That really does look like a UAZ. Straight out of DayZ, that one. I think that's the one that takes the garage points to unlock the garage. I think. Unlocked. Oh, yeah. Hello. Right, we'll stop there 1 second. Stop that engine. Change truck. Let's have a look at what you've got on the back. Utility repair, 400 points. Cool, so I could get this thing to repair that. Straight off the bat. It's just a straight up repair truck. It's not actually what I thought it might be. It's the box trailer and stuff that delivers the garage points. Right. Without falling into the volcano, although I am tempted to go in there just for a laugh. I really am tempted to go into that volcano. Oh, straight away get stuck on rocks. Fantastic. Whoa, 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 whoa. I think I'm going in anyway. Oh my god. Oh my god. Wow. How can I see over the top? Into the volcano. Yeah, I don't want to go in there particularly, but at the moment I think I am actually going to go in there. Dear. That went well. I'm just totally buried now. I can't actually, I'm going to have to winch myself out. So what I'm going to have to do... That was epic fail. What I'm going to have to do, change truck. Get back in this. And if I can... reverse myself. Because I don't think I've got any chance whatsoever of doing a 3-point turn here. That trailer is going to make it very, very, very awkward. And the camera's not helping either. I need to turn around, basically. I need to turn around. With that thing on the back, that is easier said than done. That's really weird. Have you noticed those? I'm just looking at those rocks. As I get over them, they get a really strange texture on them. And I'm not really sure why. I cannot see where I am. Right. I need to go. I need to go back up. Oh god, I'm just digging myself into the ground. It seems that this volcano is quite muddy as well. This is going south very, very quickly. I must admit the camera has confused me slightly here. I thought it was a bit more to the right than I currently am. Don't get stuck, for God's sake. Look, that's insane. How can that tree possibly support the weight of this thing on top of it? That's silly. That is silly. That thing needs to have snapped by now, because right now it's stopping me from getting out of this place. I need to miss that tree. There we go. Phew! Right. That didn't go quite as planned. I need to rescue my other truck. Which is back up the hill. Which is over here. This is the hard way. Let me tell you, I'm doing this the hard way. I want to go back over there and rescue my vehicle. There we go. Turning around on top of a volcano, that ain't easy in this thing. With a medium-sized trailer in the back. All I want to do is get over here, become a winch point, and rescue that truck, which I managed to get stuck into the half the side of a... Oh god. Oh god, let's get out of here. That's going bad. Oh crap! Again, I must admit, the camera has really, really caused that problem. That's bad. The camera just made that so bad for me. Now, I've got a real big problem, because that is a volcano disaster. Because I couldn't see what I was doing, I've managed to tip my truck over on the side of a volcano, which I was using to rescue the other truck, which I now can't rescue. Which means we're going to have to send a third truck here for a mountain rescue operation. This is insane. So I can't start the engine on that, so I can't rewrite it. This one is completely and utterly stuck. I don't think... We'll have one more go, but I really don't think I can get myself out of this hole. Although maybe I can, bizarrely enough. Once I put some proper diff lock on. Are you going to get up there? Oh, don't you dare, don't you dare, don't you dare! Oh my god. That is on tipping point. It really is. Look at that. Now I'm just burying myself. This is quite a precarious position. If I could just winch myself out of this, but there's nothing to winch myself on. There are no trees. Let's turn into it, which seems like the wrong thing to do, turn it into a volcano, but that's what's going to get me out. This is going to go one of two ways. Either into the volcano or out of it. And thankfully, yay! It went out of it. Whoa! Whoa, dude, this is the most top-heavy, unstable thing I've ever driven. Wow, God. This thing's horrendous. Look, it's stuck already. Right, can I actually winch that thing? Have I got any winch points whatsoever? There's one. Onto that, possibly. Come on, lad. Come on, you can do it. It's on a wreck. Tip the monster up. Oh god, when I break the winch, it might actually fall into the volcano. It nearly did. It nearly did. If I can get myself out of this hole here without knocking my other truck back into oblivion. There you go. Now, if I can get that way... What winch options have we got? Do you reckon that would work? I'm kind of facing the wrong way. That's the annoying thing. Maybe I just drag it down the hill a bit. If I just stop there 1 second, put the brake on. If I just drag it this way... Wow. Wow. That ain't happening. I think I might need the rescue vehicle for this one. Whoa! What's going on? What is going on? Hang on. If I pummel it down here now... That is some weird physics. No, don't you do... Oh my god! Oh my god. I'm getting out of there. That's bad. This thing is just a nightmare truck right here. I don't know if I can leave that. That is... I'm going to turn the engine off. This utility thing is... rubbish. Look at this. That That's not a good thing, is it? Right there. That's a mess. I can't believe that. I need to get... Right, I'll tell you what we need to do. If we go back to the... I could just teleport back, but that... This sounds like an excuse for fun to me. That's the one I want. So this guy here... He is the rescue truck. And this is like Thunderbirds. This is like getting Thunderbird 4 out right now. Thunderbird 4 is going to go and rescue that lot. It has been deemed mountain rescue. Okay. Let's do this. This thing can definitely get that boy out of the... Although he is the world's slowest truck. He weighs about 500 Jupiters. But, if anybody can get him out... Actually, if this thing will go up the side of that volcano, that's the question. I honestly don't know if it will. It weighs so much. Quickest way... Is... Again, it's there's no real shortcut to this. Doesn't really matter, let's go that way. Taking damage already. You can see how slow this is compared to the other one. Do you know what? I think this might get stuck on the way. It just doesn't seem to have the same agility, I think is the word. Well, it's a similar eight-wheeler because it is so big and heavy. It really doesn't want to move. I can see myself winching myself out of trouble quite a bit with this thing. This thing is so long, it's just ridiculously difficult to get around the map. It's supposed to be a rescue vehicle, but I'll be honest with you, this thing needs to rescue itself half the time. I'm going to have to try and stick to some of the major routes. It's taking 90 damage, we've not even got anywhere off the map yet. It's just amazing. Right. Do we go south side or north side? Let's go north side. I'm familiar with the terrain. Right, so if we get stuck here, I don't think we're in winching distance. I think they were going to increase the winching distance slightly. But again, it was another one of those things that they said we don't want to... You know, if we just made the winching distance really far, the game would be super easy. It wouldn't be challenging anymore. Which I can kind of understand, but then again, they should possibly consider that on hardcore, you could have a winching distance a lot smaller than on normal. So at least you could learn the game on normal, winch yourself out of trouble, not have to teleport yourself back all the time. When you go on hardcore, things get, well, hardcore. Winching distance being an obvious one. Okay, this looks bad. I can see ourselves getting stuck in the mud here. Oh, crikey, I forgot all about this. I forgot all about this massive puddle of water. This thing's taking damage at every single turn. Everything it does, it takes damage. It's like death by a thousand cuts. I mean, look at that. It's on 180 damage already. Oh, God. I can't believe I didn't die there. Hey, I'm back on the main road. Moral of the story is do not go off-roading in this thing. Oh, wait. I think the front of the vehicle doesn't help it. That overhang. The overhang over the front axle where the cabin is means that it can beach itself and dig itself in very, very easily. You know, like an ideal situation is where the wheels are in every point corner of the vehicle. And that's the ideal scenario. This, the front wheels are set so far back from that cab. that it often finds itself when it goes over the brow of a hill. It hits level ground before the wheels have got a chance to dig it out again. And that causes issues. I don't see why the front cab had to be so far in front of the axle. Or just move the axle forward a bit. What's the advantage? I can't work it out. Wow, this thing's burning 28 litres a minute. 20? 29? 30? 30 litres of fuel a minute! Oh! That's interesting. You can pull a tree down with a winch, but you try driving over it, and it's like the spring, it's like it's made out of steel. Wow. I'll just winch the tree down. There it is. There's the carnage. Up ahead. We're here, boys. We had a bit of trouble on the way, but we finally made it. We're going to rescue all of you. No problem at all. The weight of this thing, once I winch that up and pull, it's going to pull that out of there. I'm pretty certain about that. I am worried about the trailer, though. I don't know what state that's going to end up in. No, I can't get round the back. I'm just going to have to pull it backwards, I think. Right, parking brake on. Let's get a winch point from here. So I might pull it by that. That might be a good idea. We'll find out if it's a good idea in a minute. Oh, it was a top idea. Look at that. Look at that. You beauty! You absolute beauty! You know what? I might just pull it all the way down the hill, to be honest. Why the hell not? Let's face it, reversing an articulated vehicle like that is not easy anyway. With this thing, I can just pull the articulated trailer down. It should just come with me. Like that. Yay! How far I want to take this, to be honest. As long as the road's reasonably level, I think I'll just keep going down here. Those wheels are turning in the wrong direction, but it matters not. I think that's a reasonable point to do it, isn't it? Now, in terms of utilities, repair myself. That's not within range of repair, apparently. I think I already repaired that, but it might have been damaged down the side of the volcano, so I'm just going to... Yeah, it's damaged. Only a little bit. Oh, we've got none left. Utility attachment is empty. Blimey. Used all our repair points up on ourselves. Okay, so we've got this... merry little meeting in the middle. All that mess just to get that truck up there. That crappy little truck. And it is crappy. It's top heavy. It's ridiculous. If I'd have known it was for that, I wouldn't have bothered. The rescue operation I just had to pull off. Just to get that crappy little vehicle unlocked. Never mind. Can't actually see where I'm reversing. What do we want this thing? I think we want this down the road. Yeah, let's go down the road. Everybody's kind of settled up down here, aren't they? So we'll leave this in the middle here. Although it's not going to repair points, it's very, very useful. If you can get this thing to a vehicle, it can affect a rescue just because of the sheer weight of it. Which is also its downfall. That's the turn down to the beach? Yes, it is. Tell you what, let's pull into the lay-by. If that's the main road, this is like a little lay-by, isn't it? And that's a good place to park, I reckon. Just like there, like that. That'll do. Parking brake. Stop engine. Let's get back to my D357, is it? Right. Recently rescued from the side of a volcano. Let's get this thing turned. So I could possibly just take a shortcut that way, couldn't I? Although we know what just happened a minute ago when I did a shortcut. Didn't go so well. But I reckon we could just nip through there without too much trouble. His mission, should he choose to accept it, is to go and get some logs from the lumberyard, which I believe, ouch, it's back that way. Down here. Lumber! So he's going to edge his way down here now. Try not to damage the thing too much because my repair capacity is at an all-time low. Do you know, after driving that monster, this thing feels easy. I thought this was tough. At least its wheels are in the right place. So if we can get some lumber, we're well on our way to finishing the objective of Volcano, which is, admittedly by the developers, it was one of the last maps they actually put in. And it is one of the hardest. Left here, wasn't it? That's the way I like to go. That's where I normally go anyway. Tap the power. Try and miss that if I can. Okay, some trees might have died in the making of this video. Come on, up you get. There we go. Straight on, I believe, and then a right. Is that the way I went last time? No, straight on. I like how it remembers the mud trenches that you've dug. Doesn't work so well in multiplayer currently. There's a lot of things that you do with your truck that the other players don't see at the moment. But that's something they're going to work on. I think last time I went right, but I'm going to go left. I'm going to go this way. Bit of water, no problem at all. I believe it's up here. To the lumberyard. I've got the graphics on max settings, max everything. But one of the reasons I think they have it's quite misty all the time is because of the draw distance. They keep the draw distance quite small. And so what they effectively do is just fog out the distance. Which is fine. It does feel like it's misty all the time though. Aha, that was actually a better way in. Right, I've just got to turn this bad boy around. And we're ready to load up. Hopefully, the final set of logs. Oh, turning around here is so bad. It's so bad. All these rocks really don't help. It's so easy to jackknife the trailer. So incredibly easy. How do they turn this thing around in real life? It must be really hard. Especially with all the, because all these boulders get in the way and they just hit the trailer. Send it in all directions. Unless they just unhook it. They probably just unhook it, don't they? Turn it around and pick it back up again. It must be easier to do that. Right, I think we're ready for some medium logs. Clunk. We are going to have to go, if you look at the fuel levels, we're not great on fuel. We're going to have to go via our little fueling truck, which is, I believe, here. I think that's where the truck is. So if I was plotting a route, I think I would probably go out of here, there, there. I think we need to go around that way, like that. Past that one, and then just down to there, like that. I think that's the route, isn't it? Do we want to take? As night sets in. Okay, right. I think we've run out of time again, unfortunately. Oh, that's bright. Yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Please give me a thumbs up if you're enjoying spin tires and stuff. I'm going to complete this map and then I'll probably start moving on to some other stuff. Maybe another map or possibly start looking at some mods for spin tires. Leave me some comments if there's things that you think I should be looking at in spin tires going forward. There are a lot of mods, but I'm wondering if I should just work my way through the maps first. What do you think? Leave your comments and let me know. Until next time, guys, take care and happy trucking.